The blood will never lose its power. Amen, amen. We thank God. Amen. The Kraft family. Amen. Giving us those songs this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank God. Amen. For the songs. Amen. It mellows the heart. Prepare us for the word of God. Amen. And now that we are prepared, let's get our Bibles and turn to Luke 22. Man, we're going to read a few verses, beginning at 24. That's Luke 22, beginning at verse 24. And I want to talk today to you two different administrations. Two different administrations. We have the world administration, amen, and we have God administration, amen. When you find it, we ask that you stand, amen. Two different administration. Beginning at verse 24, it says, "Now there was also a dispute among them as to which of them should be considered the greatest. And he said to them, the kings of the Gentiles exercise lordship over them, and those who exercise authority over them are called benefactors. But not so amongst you. On the contrary, he who is greater amongst you, let him be as the younger, and he who is governed as he who serves. For who is greater, he who sit at the table, or he who serves? Is it not he who sit at the table? Yet I am amongst you as the one who serves." Amen. You may be seated. Amen. Two different administrations. Jesus has just instituted the Lord's Supper, beginning at verse 19 in your book. And he took the bread. Amen. Man, if we can get the other mic, because this one been going out. Man, we'll just use this one. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Give it somebody. Amen. And it says, amen, Jesus had just instituted the Lord's Supper in the mountain. And he took the bread and said, "This is my body. It's going to be broken for you. And this cup is my blood. It's going to be shed for the remission of sin. This is God's new covenant for you. Over 3 years, Jesus had been training the disciples. Amen. They walked with him. Amen. They talked with them. Amen. They went everywhere with Jesus. And now at the final hour, before Judas betrayed him, the final hour before he is arrested, amen, and he was full of the knowledge of what was going to happen. Amen. That he was going to be turned over to the Roman governor and be crucified. And his disciples are arguing over who is the greatest. Amen. That sounds like some of us want to be first. Amen. Can I get a witness? Amen. Let's go to Mark 10. Amen. And we look here. As we look in Mark 10, at verse 35, then James and John,
the sons of Zebedee came to him and saying, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask." Hey, amen. That's some boldness, ain't it? That's boldness. Hey, amen. Go to Jesus and say, "I want you to do whatever." Amen. And he said to them, "What do you want me to do?" They said to him, "Grant us that we may sit one on your right hand and the other on your left, amen, in your glory." Man, James and John, we know they was in the inner circle of Jesus. Amen. And they are asking for a high position in his kingdom. Amen. But in their minds, when they get to Jerusalem, Jesus is going to establish a political kingdom. Amen. That was in their mind. Hey, that Jesus is going to establish a political kingdom. Despite Jesus telling them over and over again, amen, that he was going to suffer many things from the elders, Matthew 16, and the chief priests and scribes, and be killed and be raised the third day. Amen. Verse 41 says, when the 10 heard it, they began to be greatly displeased with James and John. Amen. They began to be displeased and begin to argue. No doubt throughout their walk with Jesus, they have been discussing who would be the greatest in the kingdom. Amen. To sound like some of us in the world, I want to be first. Amen. Hallelujah. And on our job, I want to be first. Amen. In our politic and on the job, we talk about one another, degrade and push down others so we can be elevated. Amen. They had been discussing this as they walked with Jesus for 33 or more years. Amen. When we look back, flip back to chapter 9 and Mark 9. Amen. And we see here that then he came, verse 33, to Capernaum. And when he was in the house, he asked them, "What was it you disputed amongst yourselves on the road?" Right. And then verse 34 says, "But they kept silent." Why? Because on the road they had disputed among themselves who would be the greatest. Amen. Hallelujah. James and John, in other words, got the upper hand. That's the way they felt on them. Amen, because all of us, amen, in the same boat. All of us was fighting for the same thing. All of them wanted to be first. Amen. But James and John seemed to get the upper hands on them. Amen. Now they're mad and angry. Amen, and upset. When we look at our text in Luke 22, Jesus said in verse 25, "The king of the Gentiles exercised lordship over them, and those who exercise authority over them are called benefactors." Amen. A benefactor is one that confers benefit. Amen. The government today declared that they are our benefactor. Amen. It's not too much different now than it was then. They take money from our paycheck once a week. Some of us get paid twice a month, and some might get paid once a month. Amen. But they take a little bit of our money. Amen. Called deduction, FICA, hallelujah, health insurance, amen, city taxes, state taxes. And at the end of the year, they allow you, amen, to fill out your income tax. Amen. Yo, this is your benefactor. And now, some of them, and some of us, amen, they might take out $5,000 in the year. Some of us, depending on what you make, they might take out $10,000 out of your check and give you $1,000. They take $100 and give you $1. That's your government. That's your benefactor. Amen. But Jesus said in verse 26 and 7, he said, but not so amongst you. Amen. On the contrary, he who is greater among you, let him be as the young. And who govern as he who serves. For who is greater, he who sit at the table, or he who serves? Is it not he who sit at the table? He said, but yet I am amongst you as the one who serves. Amen. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. The world says the one who sit at the table is the greatest. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. We all want to sit at the table and be served.
Amen.
Amen. We was on a cruise a couple of weeks ago. Amen. And every day at 5:30 we were served. Amen. The waiter would come and he threw the napkin over you. Amen. I felt important. Amen. I was being served. Amen. But Jesus showed us that true greatness is in the serving. Not to be served, but it's in the serving. More than being served, Jesus said, I am amongst you as one who serves. If you think about the people who serve us, amen, the maintenance man, amen, the animal control center, amen, the dog catcher, the people who serve us, the garbage collector, can I get a witness? Amen, and when your electric bill is cut off, amen, some people's mouth get long. Amen, because they're used to the electricity. They can't look at television now. Amen, it's too hot. Man, the air conditioner's not working. But look, I come to tell you, if the president took a month off, no one would really miss him. Can I get a witness? Amen. But if the trash collector, the garbage collector took a month off, hallelujah, every one of us would miss them. Can I get a witness? Jesus is teaching us that the true path to greatness is the path of serving. Amen. Jesus said, I am amongst you as one who serves. Man, we talk about two administration. The Gentiles love those positions of authority. Can I get a witness? They love to rule over the people. They love to have dominion over people's lives. Amen. Remember that the servant is not greater than his Lord. Amen. That's what Jesus said. If your Lord and Master has washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. Amen. Can I get a witness? Two administration. And as we, as servants, should be working hard to be like Jesus. Amen. In Mark 10 and 42, Jesus called his disciples, amen, together. And said to them, come, amen, let's have a little talk.
Yes,
amen, just a little talk with Jesus. Yes. We'll make it all right. Yes. Can I get a witness?
Yes.
And Jesus sat down with him and said, now, the Gentiles, in other words, the heathens, amen, the hallelujah, they love the position of authorities and power.
All right.
They love to rule over their people. But the kingdom of God is different from that. Amen. Hallelujah. In other words, the church should not operate like the world. Amen. Every time a change comes, amen, in the world, the church want to do it too. Amen. But the church should stay out of it. Amen. Doing what the world says. Acts 6 and 3 says, seek out from amongst you seven men of good reputation, full of the Holy Spirit and wisdom, whom we may appoint over the business of serving. Amen. That's what we come to do, to serve. Jesus said, I am come to serve. Not to be served, but to serve. Many people are in the ministry for what they can get. Amen. What they can receive from the people. Can I get a witness? Amen. A lot of mega churches are in the business for what they can get. Amen. Money and popularity. But Jesus said, whoever desires to become great among you, amen, let him be your servant. If you want to be a ruler, amen, first be a servant. Can I get a witness? If you want to be the head, then hallelujah, learn how to serve. Amen. Colossians 3 says, and whatever you do in words or deeds, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God, the Father, through him. So whatever you do for your fellow man, look at it through God's eyes. Amen. Amen. Whatever you do, amen, for your neighbor, look at it through God's eyes. Can I get a witness? Amen. Amen. It might not look right to you, but in your spirit, you ought to say, I'm doing it for Jesus. Amen. Amen. Because that's what he commanded me to do. Amen. Amen. True greatness comes through serving. Yeah. When I am serving you, I see it as serving God. Amen. Can I get a witness? Amen. Verse 45 in the text says, for even the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and give his life a ransom for many. Yes. Amen. Jesus is the one who stands in the place of guilty sinners. Yes. Can I get a witness? Yes. Amen. He's the one that died for our hang-up. Yes. Can I get a witness? Yes. Amen. I come to tell you that, hallelujah, we're supposed to be servants in the house of the Lord. Yes. Amen. But so many people, amen, want to be first. Amen. Like James and John, who said, Jesus, we want to be first. Amen. We want you to do what we want you to do. Amen. But I come to tell you that Jesus said, I did not, hallelujah, come here to be served. Amen. I come, amen, as a servant. Amen. If we are Christian working in the house of the Lord, amen, we come to be servants. Can I get a witness? Amen. And I come to tell you today, amen, are you a servant in the house of God? Amen. Can I get a witness? Ain't God good? Amen. He's better to me than I've been to myself. Amen. Jesus said, I did not come to serve, to be served, but to give my life a ransom for many. And I'm so thankful that the Lord is my substitute. Amen. Hallelujah. He died. Amen. For my hang up. Amen. And I'm so glad to tell you that I am free. Amen. No more chains holding me. I'm free. Amen. Thank you, Lord God Almighty. I'm free. Amen. Are you free today? Amen. I won't be long now. I'm getting ready to close. Amen. But I think about the children of Israel. Amen. When they got to the Red Sea. Amen. They had the sea in front of them. Amen. They had Pharaoh's army behind them. Amen. Amen. And they didn't know what to do. Amen. In their mind, they said, Moses brought us out here. Amen. To die in this wilderness. Amen. So I'd rather go back. Amen. Enslaved. Amen. In order to die in Egypt. Amen. Then to die out here in the wilderness. Amen. And I want you to know today, church. Amen. Whatever addiction you might have. Amen. Whatever problem you might have. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't go back to, amen, what you used to do. Amen. I come to tell you, you don't have to stay in your addiction. Amen. You can move forward. Amen. Because I got Jesus. Amen. And that's all I need. Amen. They wanted to go back to the way they used to be. Amen. But they didn't know that God would part the sea. Amen. And they can go over on dry land. Amen. I come to tell you, whatever problem you might have. Amen. Amen. Don't go back to it. Whatever addiction you may have. Don't go back to it. Amen. That's a trick of Satan. Satan wants you to go back. Satan say you cannot get out of it. If you're gone if you get out of your addiction. Amen. He wants you to think that's all you're supposed to do. Stay right there. Amen. But I come to tell you. Amen. It might look bleak. But Jesus said, amen, I can part the sea. Amen. I can take you through. Amen. You can give it up. You don't have to do it. Amen. You can get out of whatever you're in. Amen. I come to tell you that I'm free. Are you free today? No more chains holding me. Amen. I am free. I am free. Praise the Lord. Stand. The doors of the church are open. I am free.